Blade Symphony. Is it worth a buy? Let's read it, guys. Let's read this. Prove you are the world's greatest swordsman. Engage in tactical 1v1 sword fighting, 2v2, or sandbox free for all in a tactical slash 'em up. Wow, sounds like we've never played anything like this ever before, guys.
So what is Blade Symphony? Well, it's a alpha. So there you go. It's another one of them alpha games. And it's billed as one of the best sword fighting games ever. And I'll tell you what, this got 9 out of 10 on GameSpot. That's right, 9 out of 10, guys. And the forums, all the people on the forums tend to like it. Lots of positive reviews on Steam. So, hey, must be good, eh? Well, no, it's not. It's a big pile of shit, in my opinion. It's third person, which again, I've said this before, if you're going to have a sword fighting game or anything like that, third person is the wrong choice. It needs to be first, for the simple reason of this. When you're in first person mode, you can judge exactly where the tip of your sword is in relation to the person that you're fighting. In third person mode, you just f***ing can't. You can't, because you're looking at the f***ing arsehole of the person that you're controlling, then you've got to judge the camera distance to that arsehole, then the camera distance from your arsehole to the end of your sword, and then where the enemy is. It's fucking ludicrous that you've got a sword fighting game in third person mode. I'll tell you why it's in third person mode. It's for the fucking eye candy of your little jolly animations. Fuck the animations. Hey, listen, if developers, if you're watching, the animations. I don't give a f*** how large her breasts are or how wobbly her arse is. I'm not interested. I've got a f***ing sword and I want to chop some f***ing head off with it. And I want to know exactly where the f***ing head is in relation to the end of my f***ing sword. Okay, I don't care about tits and ass. I want to kill some f***. Thank you. So there you go. So that's my stance on the third person. Now, another thing is it's very clunky. It's overcomplicated, really overcomplicated. You can't tell what the f*** you're doing half the time. You've got three stances. You've got a fast, a balanced, and a heavy stance, which, again, speaks for itself. A faster stance will give faster blows, but they'll not be as strong as a slower, heavy attack blow. If someone's using a fast stance on you, if you use a balanced, you'll win the parries because you're hitting slightly harder than them. You can grab people, then you can throw them on the floor, and then you can go and slice into them and all of that stuff. You've got your left attack, your right attack, your forward attack, you can jump backwards, you can roll, you can wall run, and all the rest of it like that. But it's all animation based, and that's an exploit that I was actually starting to pick up on after half an hour, that when someone goes into an animation, you can counter that and hit them. And that's bullshit. That's bullshit. Get rid of the fucking animations. Let's just have a sword fighting game where you can use four or five good moves with blocking and just, you know, more realistic, gets tired, stamina and all the rest of it. But we don't have any of that. I mean, the closest we've got to that is the Deadliest Warrior, which is a great game. It's much better than this shit. Believe me, it is. So, yeah, I mean, I remember years ago, maybe 12 years ago, I remember a game called Jedi Outcast, which I played to death on the PC. It was a third-person fighting game, and that was done better than this. That was actually not bad at all. But still third person, if I remember right. And we really need a good first person game. I'd love to see a Star Wars first person game with lightsaber done now with the modern technology. I really would. But anyway, back to this. The servers are empty. I went down the server list. I found one free-for-all server where you can challenge people to a duel. And I found it boring. I just ended up just running in and just slash. I'm winning duels just by slashing everybody to pieces. If you take your sword fighting extremely seriously, there's probably a game here. If you're used to the console kind of third person hacky slash games, you're probably going to like this. Me, I want a hell of a lot more out of a sword fighting game than this. I found it shallow, I found it clunky, I found the view bloody awful. So, Blade Symphony, it ain't worth a buy.